Good morning, student Sairam. I hope you all are doing well in your studies and also start solving sample papers. So, student, this is a sample number 5. Now, there are 20 questions which are optional, but we have to start from the question number 21, which are fully based on case studies. Now, question number 21 is, if anything goes wrong with the performance of key activity, the entire organization suffer. Therefore, the organization should focus on them. Explain the statement with a suitable example. Another optional question is, write down the standard used in various functional areas of organization that are used to gauge performance. So the answer is, in the first optional, the answer is the given statement refers to the importance of critical point. In this question, the question is, and when anything goes wrong with the performance, okay, and the entire organization suffer due to this. So what is this? This is a deviation. And deviation of critical point. So what we have to do, we have to analyze the critical point, okay, so in order to ensure the effective performance of the key activity in the organization. Now the second optional question, and the answer is, production, marketing, personal management and finance and accounting, means we have to compare the quantity, quality, cost and individual job performances. Now next question is, explain briefly transfer and promotion. Transfer means when anybody transfer from one department to another department or from one post to another post at the same level, okay, means same level post from one plant to the another plant of the same organization. So this is called transfer, okay. And promotion means if an employee promote from his present position to the upper position is known as promotion. Now question number 23rd is, after doing a course in online trading, Arsh started an online portal for stock trading under the name Investment Guru. He meet his school friend Ajay after a long time in a bank where Ajay had come to open a demat account. So student, why we open a demat account? If we deal with the securities, if we sell and purchase the securities, then we have to open a demat account within a bank so that we sell and purchase our securities like shares, debentures, bonds. Okay, now the question is, Arsh urged Ajay to invest in the demat account or forthcoming IPO of a blue chip company, whereas Ajay was inclined to buy existing securities of the other companies to build his investment portfolio. Means what the Ajay to purchase securities through EIPOs. EIPO means when we do in trading of securities online. Okay. Now what the Ajay said? Ajay says that Ajay want to buy and sell or want to deal with the existing securities. Now the question is, identify the two different type of capital market being referred in the above paragraph. Two marketers are there. Through EIPO, we purchase the new product or new securities. So when we issue or purchase or trade in a new securities, that means it is a primary market. And another, if we deal with the existing securities, it comes under the secondary market. Now the next question is, it's optional, is explain the first three step of trading procedure. Easy and very simple. first we have to select a broker, then we have to open a Demat account, and after that we have to place order. Next question is, explain whether the management is an art or not with example. So we first of all we have to explain all the features of art which fulfill the demand of which we have to compare with the features of management, so that we comes on the conclusion that it is an art or not. Now next question is, define the training and development, write any three benefits. So training and development is very 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 important for the betterment of an employee, for its better future, for its for enhancing their existing qualities. So and some benefits are training is a systematic learning. Next one, it enhance the employee's productivity. Next, it helps in achieving the objective or effective response to the changing environment. So these are some benefits of the training and development. Now the next question is, describe briefly the Maslow's need hierarchy theory of motivation. Student, this is a very important question and very easy. So don't get confused because of his name, the Maslow need hierarchy theory. It is a very simple need hierarchy theory that it explains how need arises from basic needs to the self-actualization need. Means first are if there is a person, its basic need is to food, clothing, shelter, then societal identification, then social affection, and after that career opportunities, and after that self-actualization, its powers, position in an organization. So all these need comes under the Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Now next one is, Roshan is a chief chef of Kidmet, a restaurant located in the city of Bengaluru. The place is known as the exquisite Mughal cuisine, specialty mutton biryani and kebabs. All the food is prepared under the Roshan's supervision. The various activities in the kitchen are initiated in according to his instructions. He is very clear and specific in issuing instructions to his subordinates in order to ensure that the smooth working of a department. He personally oversees the method of following by the chef for preparation of each dishes. He misses no opportunity to praise his subordinates for their good work. All his team members feel very happy and satisfied under his direction. He provides constant guideline to them in order to improve upon its taste and presentation, and also encourage them to motivate to innovate in the above context. So identify the two elements of directing which is mentioned here. Okay, and the next question is, briefly explain any two points to highlight the importance of directing function. And the answer is, first one is communication, supervision, leadership and motivation. So these are the terms which is very essential and which explain in the above case studies. And the above and the other importance of directing is, it initiate actions, it integrate the group effort or employees effort, and it also helps to realize their potentials. Okay, now next question is, explain the meaning of consumer as a Consumer Protection Act. Consumer means everybody is a consumer who consume things in lieu of money, means in return of money, is known as consumer. Now according to the answer is, any person who buy goods for a consideration is known as consumer. Any person who hired or avail any services for the consideration or in lieu of consideration is known as consumer. Means anybody who purchases, who hire any services is known as a consumer in lieu of money or in lieu of consideration. Now the next question is, explain any four points, highlight the importance of directing. So the importance of directing is, it initiates efforts, it initiates group effort, it initiates actions, it facilitates changes, it helpful in realizing their potential. Okay, so these are some points of importance. Now next question is, explain briefly any four points of effective working capital. What is a working capital? The capital which we use constantly in a working process is known as a working capital. And another optional is, explain briefly any four points that affect fixed capital requirement of a company. And the answer is the nature of business, the first one. The answer is nature of business, scale of operation, business cycle and seasonal factors. Now the next question is, next another optional is same. The factors which affect the capital requirement are known as, number one is nature of a business, scale of operation, choice of technique, technology upgradation and growth prospect. Now the next question is, discuss any four factors affecting the choice of capital structure. If we design a capital structure, there are many factors which affect, and some of our cash flow position of a company, interest coverage ratio on the dividend on the shares, and debt service coverage ratio, and another is return on investment. So these are the some points we kept in the mind while we deciding the structure of a capital. Now the next question is, Haldiram is a famous chain selling out large variety of product in a Indian market. Their product include chips, biscuits, sweets, squashes. It charges a comparatively high price than its competitor as it sells quality product. Besides, it offers regular discounts to the consumer and owns retail shops. It also sells its product through various grocery stores so that the product are made available to the customer at the right place in the right quantity at the right time. It regularly uses a different communication tool to increase its sale. Now the question is, the above paragraph describe the combination of variables used by the Haldiram to prepare its market offering. Now identify and explain the different variables. So the different variables are, number one is product, next price, next place. The product, the variety of product, the price which is higher but the quality is also good, and last one is place. They made available every areas. Next one is, what define price and the factor which affect. The price is a, what is the price? Price is the amount paid by the buyer or received by a seller in consideration of purchase of product or services. And the factors which affect the price while we deciding the price of a product. So the factors are, number one is pricing objective, product cost, utility of demand, competition in the market and the government policies. So these are some factors which affect while we deciding the price of a product. Next one is, explain the technique given by F.W. Taylor that brings a specialization in the shop floor. So specialization, if we talk about the specialization, that means it is a functional foremanship under which 8 bosses are there: instruction card clerk, route clerk, time and card clerk, cost clerk, specialist, speed boss, gang boss, repair boss and inspector. Next one is, what the objective of time study and standard and simplification of work. The main objective behind the time study is to assume or to calculate the average time which is taken by a worker to complete any task. And the standardization and simplification means, standardization is to fix the standard of the product of a company, and simplification means to eliminate the unnecessary things from the product, make it simple and sober and attractive to the customer. Now the next question is question number 33. Mr. Flinto runs a herbal cosmetic manufacturing company. His company is aiming to achieve a target of 20% increase in the sale in the coming year. This target can be achieved only if proper running is done. So, as to avoid the tackle uncertainties in future, explain the next 6 steps in the planning process that Mr. Flinto must take into the consideration. So, first step is developing premises. First, we have to assume things in our mind. After that, we have to identify the alternative which we want to cause for the course of actions. And after identifying, we have to evaluate whether it is suitable or not. And after evaluating all the courses of action, we have to select one of the best alternative. And after selecting, we have to implement that in a program. Okay, so these are some steps which comes under the Mr. Flinto have to take. Now, and the last is follow up action. Now, next and the last question of this sample paper is Broadcom has diversified itself into several product lines, telecommunication, engineering, and financial services. Each subsidiary is self-sufficient with their own administrative function, propagating the belief that the people can assume the responsibility for the effective implementation of their decision and should be given autonomy. This has reduced the need of direct initiative and the faster decision making. The order of the consumer are never delayed as a result of a good policy decision of top management. So we have to find out what the concept and explain any 3 points of importance of that concept which is discussed above. And the concept is, when we talk about the distribution of this authority, that means it is a decentralization. And the importance of decentralization is development initiative among subordinates, development managerial talent for the future, quick decision making, and relief to the management. Means if we distribute the authority of doing work from top level to the lower level, that means it makes a relief to the top level management, and it is also beneficial for quick decision making, and also it develops a managerial talent among the employees for the future. So these are some importance of decentralization. Now the second point of this question is name and briefly explain the suitable framework for the company. And the suitable framework for a company is divisional structure. So students, thank you, Saira.